there shall be sudden visitation. In your battles, there shall be sudden visitation. Sudden visitation. You don't sow in dry season. It is during rainy season. The rain is a prophetic symbol of blessing.
See, this symbol prophetic de la benediction.
And the rain also means the outpour of the Spirit. He doesn't want you to understand him. You can understand that he's God. Fear him, obey him, honor him. But you can never understand all his workings. The office of a prophet sees the past, the present, look into the future, and also gives solution. Serve you with gladness in my heart. I will come before his presence with singing. To know he is
God. This program is made possible by the partners and friends of Liberation TV.
Because when people are making choice, as long as the money is good, they don't see the path of God in it. As long as the business is lucrative, you say, ah, forget that thing, God will understand. God does not understand that way. Anything that will cut your service with God, leave it. God is not in it.
And now, let's join Dr. Chris Okafor for today's message.
Take your Bible.
Alors prenez vos Bibles.
Take your Bible. Take
prenez
your
vos Bibles.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Amen.
Heavenly Father, we have come before you.
Dieu tout puissant, nous sommes venus devant toi.
Walks of life to receive from you. To learn pour from recevoir, the feet of the master.
Pour apprendre du
Lord,
maître.
Open our ears.
Seigneur, ouvre nos oreilles.
Let your spirit quicken our mortal body.
Que ton esprit nous réveille.
And let your word.
Et que ta parole
wonders in our life.
Fait des merveilles
and
dans
let
nos
the
vies.
Yokes
et que les jougs
be destroyed.
Soient détruits.
And let sinners come to the kingdom
et
of your
que les pécheurs soient sauvés.
And by extension, my viewers all over
par l'extension, mes téléspectateurs à travers le monde. Là où vous êtes ce matin.
Breakthrough and intervention service.
En sécurité de percée et l'intervention.
Que
le Dieu de cette commission te donne la percée. Que le Dieu de cette commission te donne l'intervention divine. Nous disons, Satan, tu n'as pas de place ici.
Et
nous te lions au nom de Jésus. Et nous disons, toutes tes opérations. Nous brisons tout tes.
And in the name of Yeshua and Hashem,
réseau, au nom de Jésus,
and we interrupt,
nous
we
interrompons,
hinder, we overturn and we override
nous renversons
satanic oppression,
toute opération satanique, tout l'argent de Satan,
en
forme
we
humaine.
Stop and block their oppression,
nous bloquons
and
leurs opérations
that at the end of this day,
et nous déclarons
his
qu'à la fin,
alone will be glorified.
Que ton nom seul soit glorifié.
And the church of God say,
et l'Église dit,
now take your seat, take your seat.
Alors prenez
I
vos places. Je suis sur un voyage. Alors mais ce voyage va finir à votre faveur.
That amen is not anointed.
Cet amen n'est pas oint.
Now,
maintenant,
I began last week.
J'ai commencé la semaine dernière.
What a subject,
avec le sujet.
You remember? And I told you,
les mémoires.
Je
vous avais dit que c'est une série que nous allons continuer pendant un temps. Parce que vous devez comprendre quelque chose. Alors je vais commencer ce matin en vous donnant cette citation.
The value of a man reside in what he gives and not in what he is capable of receiving.
La valeur d'un homme est dans ce qu'il peut donner, pas ce qu'il peut recevoir. La valeur d'un homme se trouve dans ce qu'il donne, pas dans ce qu'il reçoit. La valeur d'un homme se trouve dans ce qu'il donne, pas ce qu'il reçoit.
what you can get, but how far you have touched the life of others.
La vie, c'est ce que tu peux faire pour toucher la vie des autres, ce n'est pas recevoir.
It's not about what you can receive,
ce n'est juste pas ce que tu peux recevoir.
But how far you have touched the life of other people.
Ce que tu as fait pour toucher la vie des autres.
And in every area of service to
dans,
God
dans tous
and
les
humanity.
Services à Dieu, à l'humanité. Alors, je vais vous montrer certaines choses très intéressantes concernant Ézéchias. Lorsque je me suis réveillé à une heure passée, priant, et plusieurs choses que, pendant que j'étudiais, plusieurs choses que le Seigneur a mis dans mon esprit qui vont vous aider ce matin. Nous allons regarder au mémoire d'Ézéchias, partie 2. Mémoire d'Ézéchias, partie 2.
But today, under it, we're going to have
Mémoire éternelle.
We're going to look at the Ezekiah's memorial.
Nous allons regarder aux mémoires de Ézéchias.
What are the things Ezekiah did?
Quelles sont les choses qu'Ézéchias avait fait? C'est facile de dire, ta parole dit, invoque-moi au jour de la détresse, je t'exaucerai. Mais la fin, et on cite toutes ces choses et la réponse ne vient pas toujours.
Vous
voyez, certains bâtiments s'écroulent. Vous avez vu et vous avez entendu parler des bâtiments qui sont écroulés pendant que d'autres sont toujours debout. Alors ça dépend de la fondation de ces bâtiments. Ce qui va être comme la base de ta intervention divine, ça dépend de la fondation que tu as posée dans ton attitude, dans les dons à Dieu. Ce jour, Ézéchias s'est dit, on a dit Ézéchias, tu vas mourir. Ézéchias a dit à Dieu, il avait dit qu'il va mourir, premièrement.
Ézéchias reminded the priest and the Levite of the poor state of the religious climate. And Ézéchias, I'm talking about.
Ézéchias, Ézéchias était le fils de Ahaz, le roi Ahaz qui est devenu un roi à 25 ans. Il était un roi très jeune, mais lorsqu'il a hérité le trône, il y avait l'idolâtrie dans le pays.
There were a lot of satanic and demonic alliances.
Il y avait tellement de
but then look at what this guy did.
Des choses démoniaques.
Number one, Ezekiah reminded the priest and the Levite of the poor state of the religious climate. Second Chronicles chapter 29.
Ézéchias s'est rappelé au roi et aux sacrificateurs de l'état spirituel du pays, l'état spirituel très pauvre.
He in the first year of his reign, in the first month, opened the doors of the house of the Lord and repaired them.
What is? In the first year of his reign, in the first month, it shows that the house of God, the temple of God, was in ruin.
Ça veut dire que le temple de Dieu était en ruine.
What did he do to it?
He opened the door of the house of the Lord and repaired them.
He opened the door of the house of the Lord and repaired. Watch, one of the things he did, he opened the door, he saw things that were not right.
Il a réparé le temple de Dieu.
He put them in order.
Il a mis en ordre.
The house of God in order for God not to put your life and business in order.
Tu ne peux pas mettre la maison de Dieu en ordre sans que Dieu te Dieu mette ta vie en ordre.
But he decided not to walk in the way ways of his father.
Il a choisi de ne pas marcher selon les voies de son père.
But he did something.
Il a fait quelque chose. Première année de son règne, voyant que la maison de Dieu était en ruine, il a commencé à mettre la maison de Dieu en ordre. Quelle était la dernière fois où tu es venu nettoyer l'église? Quelle est la dernière fois où tu as payé une chaise? en plastique pour l'église. C'est des choses que Dieu regarde. Il y a des choses auxquelles Dieu regarde. Alors le problème que l'église a, les gens pensent que servir Dieu, c'est juste se lever le matin, prendre ta Bible, s'habiller bien et venir à l'église. Après cela, tu rentres. Ça, ce n'est pas un service. Service, ce n'est pas la même chose avoir une relation avec Dieu.
He reformed the house, he put the house in order, he opened the door, saw things that were not right, places that were not painted, he painted them, rebuilt the
Alors,
house.
Alors il a refait la maison de Dieu, il a ramené le sacrificateur,
in the east street, and said unto them, hear me, ye Levites, sanctify now yourselves, and sanctify the house of the Lord God of your fathers, and carry forth the filthiness out of the holy place. For our fathers have trespassed and done that which was evil.
So he knew his father was an idol worshipper.
Alors il savait que son père était un idolâtre. Il a encouragé le sacrificateur pour servir Dieu avec toute la fidélité. Imagine, tu encourages ton pasteur. Homme de Dieu, avance. Nous t'encourageons financièrement. Nous t'encourageons en se rassurant que la maison de Dieu est en ordre. Nous t'encourageons. Et donc, pour que le mandat de 1 milliard d'âmes soit accompli.
Now, watch this. When we talk about dealing with ancestral power, he too has ancestral foundation.
Il avait un problème ancestral.
Right? His fathers have done some wrong things.
Ses parents avaient fait de certaines choses mauvaises.
Our fathers have sinned and they are no more but to bear the iniquities of our fathers. Now, where the fathers erred, he too began to arrange and make sure everything will work.
Là où son père n'avait pas bien fait, il a commencé à réparer, à mettre les choses en ordre par un service. C'est des mémoires éternelles qui parleront au jour de la détresse.
Also, they have shut up the doors of the porch and put out the lamps, and have not burned incense nor offered burnt offerings in the holy place unto the God.
They have not burnt incense, they have not offered offering to the holy place of the Lord.
Ils n'ont pas ouvert les holocaustes dans le lieu saint du Seigneur.
And he had delivered them to trouble.
Well, because they refused to do all these things.
Parce qu'ils ont refusé de sacrifier à Dieu. Le châtiment de Dieu était sur Israël
and he has delivered them to what?
Et Jérusalem.
To trouble.
Il les a livrés aux problèmes, aux troubles. Quand tu refuses de servir Dieu, quand tu es dans les problèmes, tu invoques qui? Qu'en est-il de quand c'est Dieu qui te trouble? Tu vas invoquer qui? Dieu les a livrés au trouble. Maintenant, il t'a livré au trouble. Parce que tu ne respectes pas les choses de Dieu. Tu viens à l'église quand tu veux. Tu viens à l'église en retard. Et tu rentres à l'église avant qu'on ait fini le culte. Voilà pourquoi tu vois certaines personnes.
Il
dit, mais je pars à l'église, mais ces choses n'ont pas changé dans ma vie. Donc, venir à l'église n'a rien à faire. Dieu regarde ton niveau de l'engagement.
Il parle de ton mémoire.
Alors à cause de ceci, tu peux tout comprendre ici. Ils ont refusé d'offrir des holocaustes à l'Éternel. Ainsi, le Seigneur les a livrés au problème. Que tout problème auquel le Seigneur t'a livré, qu'il ait pitié de toi. Alors, tu as besoin de te repentir. Regardons la deuxième chose que Ézéchias a fait. Tu n'as pas un mémoire dans la maison de Dieu. C'est chose qui parlera à ta faveur au jour de la détresse. Deuxièmement, deuxième chose que Ézéchias a fait, comme un mémoire, Ézéchias Deux Chroniques 29, verset 10.
to make a covenant with the Lord God of Israel, mm-hmm. that his fierce wrath may turn away from us.
You see, now something is going wrong.
Alors quelque chose ne va pas.
I will be the catalyst. You know, when you say catalyst, catalyst is something that have ability to affect.
Catalyst, c'est quelque chose qui peut.
He said, now it is in my heart.
Apporter un changement.
Il dit,
Ézéchiel dit, c'est dans mon cœur pour apporter un changement dans la maison de Dieu. En entrant, faisant des alliances avec Dieu, on dit, je veux faire des alliances avec Dieu. Puis Dieu, désormais, il ne doit plus prendre ton temps pour acquis. Il ne viendrait jamais à l'église en retard. Et je te servirai en esprit, en vérité. Deuxièmement, je ne vais pas m'amuser avec mes teams. Je vais toujours soutenir ton œuvre. Je vais toujours offrir des sacrifices et des offrandes à Dieu. Alors ça devient une partie de son alliance. Qu'est-ce qu'une alliance? Quelque chose qui est une chose sacrée. L'alliance est une chose sacrée. Une chose que tu es obligé de le faire, que c'est que tu es confortable de le faire ou non. Il a fait une alliance avec Dieu. Alors quel que soit, il reste que la maison de Dieu soit en ordre. Je dois gagner une âme dans la maison de Dieu. Je dois amener quelqu'un à l'église chaque jour. Alors tu entres dans cette alliance. C'est un Dieu qui garde l'alliance. Tu ne peux pas travailler avec Dieu par alliance, il ne garderait pas ça. Sa parole avec toi. Cette année, tu vas opérer par les alliances. Il y a des alliances qui garantissent la prospérité, la protection, la vitesse. Il y a des alliances qui garantissent la richesse. Et je peux entendre amen quelqu'un. Ce jour, nous allons opérer selon les alliances. Quelqu'un dit alliance. Alors vous devez comprendre ceci. Avant que tu le dises, Ézéchias connaissait son valeur dans le royaume. Il avait dit, Dieu augmenta 15 ans. Que ton alliance soit le facteur dominant contre toute puissance démoniaque contre toi. Tu dois parler. Que tu dois dire, Seigneur, à cause de tel ou tel service que je te rends, tu peux prospérer. Tu peux devenir le plus riche de ta génération et de ta famille. Mais il y a une alliance qui doit amener cela à l'accomplissement. Jusqu'à ce que tu suives les principes divins, je le répète encore. Dieu des sentiments. Que tu as dit, oh Dieu, j'ai souffert, j'ai souffert. Mais quelqu'un dit, oh, j'ai souffert. Alors, mais tu as souffert. Tu souffres, mais tu n'es pas prêt à faire ce qu'il faut faire. Alors, tu n'as pas une alliance qui parle à ta faveur. Tu n'as pas de mémoire. Il va catalyser. Parler à ta faveur, que Dieu va regarder. Dieu peut porter des regards. En tant qu'élève, si tu ne composes pas l'examen, il n'y a rien que le professeur peut bien corriger. Certains d'entre vous, vide. Certains d'entre vous, vous n'avez même pas d'alliance avec Dieu. Alliance veut dire il y a des choses que tu dois obéir, tu dois faire à cause de l'alliance. Aujourd'hui, nous allons entrer dans une alliance.
To even say amen becomes a problem too.
Même pour dire amen, c'est un
now,
problème.
Thirdly,
troisièmement,
Ezekiah persuaded the priests and the Levites to take up their position and assume their duties once more. Because then the whole city, the whole temple was lying in ruin. There was idolatry everywhere. But this guy brought reform. Even the pastors, the priests,
le pasteur, le sacrificateur.
We are so discouraged that they abandoned their duty post.
Ils ont abandonné le poste de
2 Chronicles 29 verse 11.
My sons, be not now negligent, for the Lord hath chosen you to stand before him, to serve him, and that you should minister unto him and burn incense.
That means there were times the priests were discouraged. There were times the priests were downcast because they were also, they are also human beings.
And
it took the intervention of Hezekiah, who says, come up, man, come. If we leave the house of God, who will put it in order? Man, we need to go do this. Come on, man. This one said, I don't have a car. He said, you take this car. This one said, I don't have. He was encouraging them.
Il les encourageait.
And God saw one man single-handedly brought the people to him.
Le peuple.
And God said, such man is important.
Dieu dit, cet homme est important.
So, according to Albert Einstein, he said, the life of a man does not consist of what he can receive,
ne consiste pas ce qu'il peut recevoir,
but of what he can give.
Mais de ce qu'il donne.
And that's why they say, givers don't lack.
Parce pourquoi on dit, ceux qui donnent ne manquent jamais.
Fourthly,
quatrièmement,
Hezekiah's persuasion produced Levitical reforms. Hezekiah's persuasion produced Levitical reforms. 2 Chronicles 29,
la conviction des
verse 12 to 19.
We'll have time to read it on. Go ahead.
Then the Levites arose. Mahath the son of Amasai.
You see, after his encouragement, the men that left their duty post, they arose. You can talk to somebody and say, man, you need Jesus in your life. By the reason of your testimony, you tell them what God of liberation is doing, they will arise and follow you. Many of you came to talk this morning, you did not invite anybody. You did not talk to anybody because of about Jesus Christ. You did not talk to anybody about the great God of liberation, what he's doing here. So what is the basis of God intervening for you?
After that, après quoi?
He persuaded them. There was so much persuasion. And they arose. Begin from that verse again.
Then the Levites arose, Mahat the son of Amasai, and Joel the son of Azariah, of the sons of Kohathites, and of the sons of Merari, Kish the son of Abdi, and Azariah the son of Jehalil, and of the Geshonites, Joah the son of Zima, and Eden the son of Joah, and of the sons of Elizapan, Shimri and Jael, and all the sons of Asaph, Zechariah and Mathaniah, and of the sons of Heman, Jehiel and Shimei, and all the sons of Jetuhon, Shemaiah and Uzziel. And they gathered their brethren and sanctified themselves and came according to the commandment of the king.
According to the commandment of the king.
By the words of the Lord to cleanse the house of the Lord. And the priest went into the inner part of the house of the Lord to cleanse it and brought out all the uncleanness that they found in the temple of the Lord.
They brought out all the uncleanness they found in the temple of the Lord. Who is behind
it?
Who is behind it?
Dans la maison du Seigneur.
Now let me ask you a question. Everybody, hold on. Hold on, look at me.
Alors,
look at me.
Regarde-moi.
You have 5 children.
Tu as 5 enfants.
Or you have 10 children. Or you have 3 or 7. Amen, somebody. Now every other one of them, their eyes is always up.
Chacun de leurs yeux
but you have one
mais tu as un enfant
who takes care of things,
qui prend soin des choses,
puts things in order,
met les choses en ordre.
When he sees something is going wrong,
lorsqu'il voit
that
quelque
one
chose
puts
ne va
it in order.
Il le met
when
en
you
ordre.
Come, make sure your house and everything is okay.
Il
amen, somebody.
La maison est en ordre.
Which one will you be closer to?
Alors, à qui est-ce
the
que
one
tu
that scatters?
Plus proche?
Now you see, that form the basis of a lot of time they say, oh, the father loved this one than this one. Am I correct?
You have
seen a lot of times the father gives inheritance to one person.
Le père donne l'héritage à une
personne. The reason is the same way it is for God.
La même chose avec Dieu.
So that's why God could go to Hezekiah could go to God and say, God, if you do
Dieu,
this,
si
I will know you are God of injustice.
Je saurai que tu es Dieu de l'injustice.
God, you know it, I cannot die. When he began to name all these works, all these memorials, God said, hey, we're in trouble, Hezekiah cannot die. Man, look at the things this guy have done. What have you done?
Les choses que ces gars accompli.
Read on.
Qu'est-ce que tu as fait?
And they brought out all the uncleanness that they found in the temple of the Lord.
All the uncleanness. When was the last time you came and said, oh, this part of the church is not looking good. We need to finish the work. We need to paint it. They brought out all the uncleanness. Things that we are not okay in the house of God. This place is hot. We don't have enough air condition. Okay, by next week, I will see how many I can buy. These are the things God looks at. You don't always wait for me to call you or a pastor to say, oh, we need this, we need that. When you come to church, just as when you go to your house, when you see that the light is not working, the bulb is burnt, what do you do? You replace it. Nobody tells you to do that. So why will you wait for somebody to tell you to do it in the house of God?
Have you ever wondered why the kingdom of darkness is trembling? Have you ever wondered why the hosts of heaven are rejoicing? Liberation City. At the Liberation City, heaven bears witness.
You were not a Christian before, you were a Muslim.
I'm a Muslim.
It was because of this you gave your life to Christ about a week ago.
It's true, sir. Today making a week.
Today making a week.
This can go before.
The word of God comes alive.
The rain is a prophetic symbol of blessing.
Symbol prophetic benediction.
And the rain also means the outpour of the Spirit.
The power of God is made manifest, and chains are broken without apologies.
The curse broken in the mighty name of Jesus Christ.
Be a part of this great move of the Spirit. Watch us online at www.liberationcity.org/liberationtv. Liberation City, liberating lives.
He persuaded them, and immediately they arose.
Ils se sont levés.
They gathered themselves together. He encouraged them in the Lord. And they began to clean the house of God, of the Lord, put things in order. And the house of God began to bubble again. You cannot make the house of God be in order and your life not be in order.
It's not possible.
It's not possible.
C'est pas possible.
As surely as the Lord liveth.
Si longtemps que le Seigneur vit.
And the Levites took it to carry it out abroad into the brook Kidron. Now they began on the first day of the first month to sanctify, and on the eighth day of the month came they to the porch of the Lord. So they sanctified the house of the Lord in 8 days. And in the 16th day of the first month, they made an end. Then they went in to Hezekiah the king and said, we have cleansed all the house of the Lord and the altar of burnt offerings with all the vessels thereof, and the showbread table with all the vessels thereof. Verse 19. Moreover, all the vessels which King Ahaz in his reign did cast away in his transgression have we prepared and sanctified, and behold, they are before the altar of the Lord.
You see to that. Remember, Hezekiah was the son of Ahaz, and Ahaz has transgressed, carried the things of God, even took it to idol. So there was so much idolatry in the land. But one man came and brought about reform. So the untimely death that killed his father did not kill him. When the untimely death, this is something as a result. Our fathers have sinned and they are no more. As a result of idolatry, the father was cut short untimely. Now he was 25 years old when he became king in Israel. Now this time, the same years his father died. He was about to die at the same time. Now the prophet came and said, hey, put your house in order. You are going to die. Why? Because there is something, there is a covenant the father has entered into. But by revelation and by understanding, he began to deal with what dealt with his father.
Il a commencé à traiter avec ce qui avait détruit son père.
And the yoke of sudden death was broken in the family. May everything that follows other people in your family, may you be the man, may you be the woman to end that cycle in your family. Now, this one has nothing to do with prayer. This has everything to do with service.
Ceci a fait avec le service.
Nobody's talking about prayer
yet.
In every reform he has made, in every memorial he has built, you have not seen any single place he talked about prayer. To put the house of God in order, that means you're talking about prayer.
Mais la maison de Dieu en ordre, c'est faire parler de la prière.
Somebody asked me one time. He said, in one sentence, define a church.
En une phrase, fait dans la définition d'une église.
I said church.
Il dit église.
It's not just a place of worship.
C'est pas juste un lieu d'adoration.
You know why?
De prière.
I am following the footsteps of the master, who is the master of prayer. The Bible told us that Jesus started with prayer and did what? And that with prayer. So Jesus said, have you not heard that the house of my father shall be called the house of prayer? So this man prepared a house for people to pray and bring so bad to God. And tell me why God will not show up, even if he's a God of injustice. But the God I serve is a God of justice. Amen, somebody. Now let's see the 15th Hezekiah did. Hezekiah gathered the leaders of the city and led them to the temple. He gathered the leaders of the city and led them to the temple. 2 Chronicles 29 from verse 20 to 24. When was the last time you gathered people? When was the last time you brought your friends? When was the last time you brought someone to the church? This morning you are coming, I'm sure 80% of you did not invite anyone to the church. He gathered the leaders. He's a leader. So he gathered people like him. You are a businessman. You should also be able to gather businessmen like you. You are a student. You should be able to gather students like you. You are a banker. You should be able to gather your fellow banker. Let's see what the guy did. He's a leader. So it was easy for him to gather leaders like him.
Then Hezekiah the king rose early and gathered the rulers of the city.
You see, he gathered the rulers of the city. You are a businessman. Gather all the businessmen of the city. You are a banker. Gather all the bankers in the city. Amen, somebody. You are a student. Gather all the students in your school. Tell them about Jesus Christ. Bring all of them to Liberation City. He gathered them together. This forms the part of memorial. Lasting memorial that will speak for you. That will speak even for your generations to come. And they gathered the ruler. What happened?
And went up to the house of the Lord.
You see, he gathered them. Where did he carry them to? To the house of the Lord. And you are coming every time you come. You come alone, you go alone. He gathered rulers together.
Il a rassemblé les rois ensemble.
He gathered the rulers together.
Il a rassemblé les rois ensemble.
He gathered the rulers together.
Il a rassemblé les rois ensemble.
In every profession you find yourself, you should also be able to gather people together.
Tu dois rassembler les gens de ta profession.
Whether you are a career person, businessman, businesswoman, whether you are a housewife, there are housewives like you to gather them.
Il y a des femmes mariées comme toi, faut
whether you are a house husband,
que tu sois un mari.
There are house husbands like you too.
Rassemble-les également pour les amener.
Because
à la
if there is
de
housewife,
Dieu.
There should be house husband. Gather all of them.
Rassemble-les tous.
What makes a woman housewife when a woman?
Qu'est-ce
the man is the one doing things, and the woman is the one putting the house in order, right? So the woman becomes a housewife. But when the man is the one who doesn't do anything. Is at home,
quand l'homme fetching ne fait
water,
rien,
washing plates,
c'est la femme qui
and
fait
the woman
tout.
Doing things. So it too becomes a house husband.
Il devient un mari de maison.
Amen.
Amen.
So you should be able, that one alors, apart, I'm joking. Na joko.
Don't take I'm serious. Je m'amuse. Je pense pas que je suis sérieux. Je m'amuse juste.
Now you too, you should be able to gather
alors,
people
aussi,
around you.
Tu dois te
now what does the guy did? He gathered all the rulers of the city because he's a leader. So it's easy
rois.
For him to talk to fellow leaders like him.
C'était facile pour qu'il parle au roi comme lui. Il a
rassemblé by next Sunday when you are coming, you will come with nothing less than 3 persons.
Tu ne viendras pas avec moins
de
3
personnes.
Let it
form the basis of your memorial this year. Your amen is not even good.
Ton amen n'est pas bon.
It's like you are still, part of you is still in, at home.
C'est comme si
part of you is still sleeping. Now in Jesus' name I command you to wake up.
Au nom de Jésus, je te commande, réveille-toi.
I say when you are coming on Sunday, you will come with how many of you? 3.
Avec
you are a businessman. Look for business people around you. Do what? Bring them.
Tu es un homme d'affaires, je viens avec les hommes d'affaires.
He led them.
Il
the Bible says that he that winneth a soul is what? Why?
Il dit celui qui gagne une âme est sage.
He said those who speak to me about others, I will speak to my father about them. So evangelism, if you think that evangelism started in the days of Jesus, Hezekiah was a great evangelist in his own right.
Ezekiel, c'était
un every Christian should be evangelist.
Et tout chrétien devait être un
this
evangeliste.
Gospel must be preached to every creation.
Cet évangile then the end will come.
You don't need to be a pastor.
Créatures.
You don't need to carry a microphone.
But
you can
pasteur,
be an evangelist in your business place. While you go for time out with your friend, you say, oh, can I talk to you about Jesus? You talk to them about Jesus. I'd like you to be in my church this Sunday. You tell them what God is doing.
Je
please come, the fire will convince you.
Je lui dis, viens. Je vois ce que Dieu est en train de faire
you
dans ce
have
lieu.
Every supernatural equipment and material that makes evangelism easy.
Vous avez tout le matériel qui peut rendre l'évangélisation facile pour vous aussi longtemps.
Read on. Let's see what the guy did.
And they brought seven bullocks and seven rams and seven lambs and seven he goats mm-hmm. for a sin offering for the kingdom and for the sanctuary and for Judah. And he commanded the priests, the sons of Aaron, to offer them on the altar of the Lord.
He commanded the priests,
he commanded
the sons of Aaron,
les fils d'Aaron,
he commanded the priests, the sons of Aaron, to do what?
To offer them on the altar of the Lord.
You know what it means?
You say,
oh,
à l'éternel,
Dr. Chris Okafor, your sacrifice.
Ton sacrifice.
You say, oh, take this, do more crusade.
Fais des croisades.
Say, do more crusade.
Fait des croisades.
Oh, what will it take to complete the church or paint part of the church?
Mais
oh, what will it take?
Peindre l'église.
He commanded them your il service in the house of God.
Ton service dans la maison
and many
de
of you
Dieu.
Take this for granted. That's why
vous
the enemy has made you so wicked that you are even wicked to your own deliverance.
Que l'ennemi t'a rendu très méchant même.
That's why when they talk about offering is a problem for you.
Quand on parle des offrandes, c'est un problème pour toi.
You can come to the house of God with money.
Tu peux venir dans
you can
la maison,
have 10,000 in your pocket, but you will be looking for 200
poche.
To give.
Mais tu cherches 200 pour donner comme
when there's an instruction that you should come out with 5,000 offering, is a problem
5,000.
To you. But you can declare Shakis man
mais tu peux déclarer
in one place. You say, brother,
poisson,
take any bottle you want.
Your frère, prends
I'll pay.
Tout ce que
and
tu
that
veux,
bottle will eventually destroy you one day.
Et ces bouteilles
and that time they will carry you.
Te détruira
or they will poison you one day. They will carry you. Oh God, God, hear me, man of God, hear me, man of God, pray for me. Man of God, pray for me. But that time, when God was giving instruction, telling you the things you should do, you are not doing anyone.
Tu ne faisais pas.
He said to the merciful, I will show myself merciful.
Dieu miséricorde. Je le montre la miséricorde.
To the forward, I will show myself forward. So how do you want to follow God? That determines or depends how God follows you.
La manière que tu suis Dieu,
not about what you can receive, but what you can give. Givers never lack.
Ceux qui donnent ne manquent jamais. Il faut focaliser sur ce que tu dois
so they killed the bullocks, and the priest received the blood and sprinkled it on the altar. Likewise, when they had killed the rams, they sprinkled the blood upon the altar. They killed also the lambs, and they sprinkled the blood upon the altar. And they brought forth the he-goats for the sin offering before the king and the congregation, and they laid their hands upon them, and the priests killed them, and they made reconciliation with their blood upon the altar to make an atonement for all Israel, for the king commanded that the burnt offering and the sin offering should be made for all Israel.
For all Israel. You know what it means?
To Israel.
Now, the priest will not say, oh, we would have done it, but there is no money, no sacrifice.
Oh,
he made sure that there was so much prosperity in the house of God. He made sure that things were available in the house of God. He made sure that the priest will not complain. He encouraged the priest on every side. He made sure that there is nothing lacking in the house of God. You cannot give to God and God not respond to you. If the scriptures cannot be broken and the word of God cannot be broken, that is why he said, true prosperity shall the gospel be spread abroad. And you saw a man that was so much using prosperity in the house of God. He made sure that the priest doesn't lack anything in his time as long as the guy sits on the throne. So that's why when God told him, hey man, you will die. He allowed the prophet to deliver the message. By the time the prophet was done, he said, prophet, I've heard what you say. God bless you.
Merci.
Take this to transport. It was even the man who came to pass message of death to him. He even gave him money. Say, use this one. I'm sowing this seed. You take it. He went back to God.
Il allait à Dieu.
And said, God,
dit, Seigneur,
have you forgotten
as-tu oublié
how I led people before you?
Quand j'ai
conduit have you
les
forgotten
gens
how I put your house in order. Your house was totally left in ruin. Have you forgotten how I removed all the idols? My father,
God,
try it. I will know you are unfaithful, God. Try it. You come to a level in life.
Tu arrives à un niveau dans la vie.
When you talk to God as friend.
Tu parles à Dieu comme
you
un ami.
Talk to God because you have a level, you have a platform.
Parce
you already
platform,
in relationship with God by the reason of
Dieu,
your commitment and your dedication. That is when trouble comes, you can stand and say, God, you know what I've done. You know how many times I've brought people before you. You know every Sunday how I bring
Dieu,
souls to you. You know how I support
the
kingdom. You know how I make sure that souls are won. You know how I make sure that things are in order. God! God, try it.
Dieu, si tu veux être un Dieu injuste, essaye ça.
God was with apology. God say, God began to call him Ezzy. No, sorry. It's okay. Don't worry.
We'll
rectify it. Even though your father died in the same years. But your sacrifice and your dedication does not warrant you to die the same way. Because we still need your service in the house.
Mais nous avons encore besoin de ton service dans la maison.
We still need your service.
Nous avons encore besoin de tes services.
Your services are still needed in my house.
Tes services sont encore. Il faut
you are such a catalyst.
Tu es un catalyste.
A reformer. You are a game changer.
Celui qui a changé
I can't afford to lose you. Losing you will be too expensive for my kingdom. Even though the law in your family says you must die at this age by the reason of what your father has done. But by the reason of your sacrifice, by the reason of your dedication, by the reason of your commitment, you have broken out of what killed your father. You have broken out of what stopped your father. It means your memorial says you cannot die the way your father died because your father died without memorial. But you have a memorial. Your memorial will speak for you in the time of trouble. That is why it says, pay your vow, offer your offering and your sacrifice, then call upon me in the day of trouble.
Il faut croire au jour de la détresse. Ton sacrifice parlera à ta faveur au jour de la détresse. Voilà pourquoi le Seigneur dit, paye tes vœux.
How can you clap when your altar is empty? Look at your
hand,
it's like a kiwi. Amen. You know what they call ikiri? How can you clap? Look at your hand.
Regardez vos mains. Comment est-ce que tu peux applaudir?
When you get home, if you are able, ask your parents or your grandpa, ask him what is ikiri. Amen. Na joko.
Bon, ça c'est les amusements, c'est l'immense, ce que je viens de dire.
He gathered leaders.
Il rassemblait la
dîme. Every one of
anciens,
you. By the mandate of 1 billion souls God has given to us. Don't just come here and sit down. You wear nice, you dress well. Please, it's not enough to dress well. Dressing will not take you to the kingdom. It is what you have done that you will be remembered for.
C'est ce que tu as fait. Qui parlera?
It's what you have done. Imagine you just pick up your Bible. In the morning you are coming, you are not calling. Hey, the person, where are you? Are you in that bus stop? The person says, I don't have to say, come, I will pay your transport. These are the things God looks at.
Ça c'est des choses que Dieu regarde quand tu permets les transports aux gens qui n'ont pas de transport.
Where is your lasting memorial?
Parce que c'est toi qui les as invités. Où est ton mémoire?
That matter would have been solved long ago.
Ce problème devait être déjà résolu. Mais
but you are not keeping with your memorial. Look at the things I'm listing as Ezekiah did.
Quatre semaines pour finir les mémoires.
For you to know the level of what this man have done.
Alors pourquoi vous puissiez.
I too, I am raising memorial that will speak for me.
Alors moi-même je fais.
Amen, somebody.
Les sacrifices et les
you don't understand.
Parleront à ma faveur. Cinquième point.
Number
chose.
Six, I mean. Ezekiah introduced music to the house of God.
Ezekiel
Second Chronicles 29, verse 25 to 26. He introduced
Deux
music.
29, verset
music
25
into the house of God.
Il a
and many
musique
of you think
dans la
music
de Dieu.
Doesn't mean anything.
Certains d'entre vous pensez que la musique ne veut
as
rien dire.
As long as God is concerned.
Aussi longtemps
so
que
much.
Tu es concerné.
Because music is a help ministry under the prophetic ministry.
La musique, c'est un ministère.
Every true prophet loves music.
Tout vrai prophète aime la musique.
Every true prophet loves music.
Tout vrai prophète aime la musique.
A prophet cannot be in a right state of mind to minister to do anything. But play music for him.
Un prophète peut ne pas être en
esprit
pour
un ministère,
mais joue la musique.
Play play music for him. You know, the Jehoshaphat and the other two kings went to Elisha in 2 Kings chapter 3. They say, we don't know how to fight these people. We came to inquire from you what we must do. Because we know when God speaks, that is the final. He said, well, I'm not supposed to speak to you because I'm not in the right frame of mind. I am discouraged because your people are serving, you know, they are worshiping idol. He said, but nevertheless, because I recognize your presence, Jehoshaphat, but then I'm not in the right state. But if you can get me a mistress to play. And the Bible said it came to pass. They brought a mistress. Why the mistress began to play? That's why, as someone in the music team, you don't just wake up in the house in the morning from your house and say, let me go to church for going sake. You have to prepare because your music is supposed to form a basis of God's operation in the house of God. So you don't go to live a bad life and come to church and carry a microphone. Now you sing, heaven will not move.
Tu peux parler mener une mauvaise vie et tu viens à l'église porter des micros pour rendre ministère. Tu
for the hour has come when those who worship me will do so in truth and in spirit.
L'heure est venue que ceux qui l'adorent doivent le faire
en esprit et en vérité. You cannot be blessed as a singer when your music is not bringing God's glory. Because your music is supposed to bring the glory to feed the temple.
En tant que chante, quand
you don't prepare yourself. The Bible says, Ezekiel told them, sanctify yourself.
Fais pas descendre la gloire de Dieu. Ezekiel le dit de se sanctifier.
And you can be denied and be robbed of your blessing. Because when a music, when a song doesn't move God, it becomes entertainment.
Quand son son ne mouve pas Dieu, ça devient juste une
formalité. It becomes entertainment. When your music, when you sing, your singing is supposed to move God. Because in Psalm 22 and verse 34, it says, for the Lord God dwells in the praise of his people. And the Bible says, Paul and Silas, they pray. While they were singing, that God came down. The Spirit of God came down. If your music cannot bring down the Spirit of God, then you lack spirit yourself. You need to always prepare. How many of you in the singing and the music department pray for 2 hours, 3 hours last night? How many of you prayed midnight prayer last night? Stand up. How many of you did? You prayed midnight prayer before coming. You see what I'm saying? So the rest of you, you didn't pray. And you carry my, oh, come and join me. Which hallelujah?
Combien plus d'entre vous, vous n'avez pas prié dans la nuit avant de venir
chanter? It's not all about dressing well.
Ce n'est pas juste
s'habiller bien. Wearing fine suits, fine gown.
Bon costume.
Fine gown without fine spirit is equal to a fool.
Même si tu portes des beaux vêtements, sans un beau, sans que
are you hearing what I'm saying? You have to become conscious. Oh, let me not do this. What? Let me not do this against God. Let me not do this. Oh, I want to be at my best. The Bible said, while this guy was singing, the Spirit of God came upon Elisha.
That means sometimes
I might not even be up to the level I want to operate. But by your own singing, I can go to a level where I don't want to go. I can enter into a... Are you hearing what I'm saying, somebody?
Ça veut dire que parfois je peux ne pas même vouloir prophétiser, mais par votre chanson, je peux aller à cette dimension prophétique.
Praise
parce
is
que
a
la
divine
louange
summon.
Est une invocation divine.
Praise is a, Dieu. So God does not eat
la louange
vegetable
invoque
or
Dieu. Dieu ne mange pas les légumes,
but
soit le
sacrifice.
Mais il mange la
that's
louange
why in Genesis chapter 8, the Bible says when Noah has offered sacrifice to him,
quand
when
Noé
God perceived the soothing aroma, God said, eh?
You have perçu
who they cook?
Cette
who?
Bonne odeur de ce sacrifice.
You know when you are coming to the house
quand
and you stay at the gate,
maison,
you perceive some kind of wicked aroma.
Tu peux percevoir.
You move straight to the kitchen when you get home. You say, ah, I don't know, I came to see how you are doing.
Aroma.
You don't now lie. It's the food that brought you, not that you came.
Alors
it's the aroma.
Dis, mais comment ça va? C'est juste l'odeur du.
God came down.
La cuisine.
I said, Noah, I did verse before, but make, as
Noé,
I eat this thing, I know verse again.
So fâché,
from today,
non, je suis plus fâché.
Flood, I will never destroy the earth with flood. This world with flood again. As long as the earth remains, seed time and harvest time will not cease.
Si longtemps que cette terre existe,
someone built a memorial. So it doesn't matter what happens today, no matter what happens in the world, flood will never consume this world, this earth again. You know why? Somebody's memorial is
ce
speaking.
Monde ne peut plus souffrir les nuages à cause d'une mémoire de quelqu'un qui a signé ça.
Where is your service?
Alors où est ton service?
When you die,
quand tu meurs,
how much you have in the bank will not celebrate you.
Ce que tu as en compte,
I hope you know.
Il va pas te célébrer.
When I'm done with Ezekiah, I will show you the memory of Dorcas.
Quand je vais finir,
what
je
Dorcas did. When she died, it was not a bank account that was crying. It was men and women, widows, less privileged that she has touched. And they were crying. They said, God, this woman doesn't deserve to die.
They
were raising the memory of what she has done. God, they went to protest. They went to protest before God. They said, God, they say, you know, nobody is a graduate in my family because of poverty. This woman made me a graduate. God, you know, nobody ever built a house. This woman did this. By the time God saw all the
memorial,
God said, hey,
que le peuple présente
angel, Gabriel, that woman has already gone, but call her back, bring her back.
Dit, oh, Hans,
the woman that was dead
ramène
came back to life.
Cette femme qui était mort revint en vie. À cause de son mémoire, à cause de ce qu'il a fait pour le Seigneur.
Life, I say again, does not consist
la vie
of
ne
what you can receive.
À ce que tu reçois.
But it's all about what you can give.
Mais ça, ce que tu peux donner.
Somebody asked me, say, don't you rest?
Don't you rest?
Every week you're on the road.
Chaque fois, chaque semaine, tu es en route.
Amen.
Amen.
I say, I'm not resting.
Je dis, je me repose
but
pas.
A day will come where my unrest will speak for my generation.
On
a day will come
and
where my unrest, when I go to heaven, it will
quand
say, my son, welcome.
On me dira,
I saw when you went to Kwara State. I saw when you went to Cameroon. I saw when you went to America. I saw when you added thousands of souls to my kingdom.
We
do this every day from Monday to Monday to Sunday, no rest.
Du lundi à dimanche,
don't feel for me. Don't say, ah, but man of God, it's not good now. You should make our time to rest. Don't feel for me. Feel for yourself.
Pas besoin de vos sentiments.
I am building a lasting memorial.
Si tu veux avoir
and I will show you what these things have done for me.
Je suis en train de bâtir les mémoires.
Amen, somebody.
Qui parleront en ma faveur.
Somebody say memorial.
Quelqu'un dit mémoire.
Last but not the least.
Dernier point de mémoire.
Ezekiah taxed the priest to offer burnt offering. Second Chronicles verses 27 to 28.
And Hezekiah commanded to offer the burnt offering upon the altar. And when the burnt offering began, the song of the Lord began also with the trumpets and with the instruments ordained by David, king of Israel. And all the congregation worshipped, and singers sang, and the trumpeters sounded, and all this continued until the burnt offering was finished.
Okay, before this, there's one I mentioned, verse 25 to 26. How he commanded the people. Yeah, he introduced music to the house of God. Read that one before we come to this one again. Okay, start from 25 to 28.
And he set the Levites in the house of the Lord with cymbals.
He set the Levites in the house of God with what? With cymbals.
With psalteries. With harps.
That means he brought powerful musical instruments.
The lute et des
lineries and the rest.
Selon l'ordre de David.
I was talking to one of my sons.
Je parlais à l'un de mes fils dans le Seigneur. Je lui ai dit,
we are renting instruments when we go for crusade.
Nous louons
sometimes
les instruments
we use 2 million 500,000 per day and the rest
quand on parle,
depending on
the
because
croisades.
We use stadiums.
Parce que nous utilisons les stades. Nous
like
louons les
instruments.
Last
crusade we use the stadium. We have over 45,000 to 50,000 people. Now to power it with instruments and generate, he said, what will it cost?
Je parlais à l'un de mes fils.
To get a complete instrument for an outreach.
Il m'a dit, qu'est-ce que ça va coûter pour avoir les instruments, pour les sorties? J'ai demandé.
And they inquired, they told me that it would take 9 million naira.
Ils m'ont dit, ça va coûter 9 millions. Je lui ai dit,
he said, is that what, are you sure is that? I said, yes.
Il m'a demandé, est-ce que je suis?
He said, I'll bring the money. He wrote the check.
Il a crié
and the check did not bounce. Hold on. Hold it. Why are you clapping? Everything you will just clap. And you don't do anyone to clap. You are clapping for what another man has done.
Vous applaudissez pour ce qu'une autre personne a fait. Il faut applaudir pour ce que toi-même as fait.
Are you hearing what I'm saying?
Ce que tu as fait. J'ai parlé à un fils, il a créé un chèque de 9 millions pour les justement
now,
pour les croisades.
You know what he has done? Generational harvest.
Ça c'est la moisson générationnelle.
Every time we have ordered for it, paid the money. Every time that thing comes, every time I hold microphone,
chaque
and thousands of people give their life to Jesus,
et les milliers de personnes donnent la vie.
He's a shareholder
dans
in the anointing.
Jésus.
And you are not a shareholder. You see why I ask you not to clap?
Bénédiction.
Yeah. I have built a lot of memorial and I'm still building.
Mémoire, je
I have
continue.
Built memorial by offering, by sacrifice.
Mémoire,
I have built memorial by fasting and by
je
prayers. I'm still fasting today even as I talk to you
je
for 9 years now.
Neuf,
I have built memorial
j'ai bâti des mémoires
by my services to God
mes services
and
à
humanity.
Dieu
I have built memorial by reaching less privileges and we are still doing that. Read on.
And he set the Levites in the house of the Lord with cymbals, with psalteries, and with harps, according to the commandment of David and of Gad, the king seer, and Nathan the prophet. For so was the commandment of the Lord by his prophets. And the Levites stood with the instruments of David, and the priests with the trumpets. And Hezekiah commanded to offer the burnt offering upon the altar. And when the burnt offering began, the song of the Lord began also with the trumpets and with the instruments ordained by David, king of Israel. And all the congregation worshipped, and the singers sang, and the trumpeters sounded, and all this continued until the burnt offering was finished.
You see, they were praising God.
Il
These
Dieu.
Are the things Hezekiah did.
Enfin,
and you can see the reason why he went to God
voilà
and said, God,
Dieu,
have you
Dieu.
Forgotten all my services before
et
you?
Tu
why do you want me to
come?
And the Bible said, God sent the same prophet and said, go, I am adding 15 years.
Dieu a envoyé le même prophète dit,
and when Hezekiah
ans,
saw the prophet coming, Hezekiah was laughing.
Quand Hezekiah a vu le prophète
I perceive, I can paint a picture here. Hezekiah was laughing. When it's the moment he saw Isaiah, he took
Esaïe
another wine.
Revenu, il a pris de vin.
Prophet, come.
Prophet, viens,
prophet.
Viens.
Wait till God talk again.
Qu'est-ce
God
que
said
Dieu
15
a dit
years
encore?
Old. He said, I know now, I know.
Il lui a dit que 15 ans. Il dit, oh, je sais. Je sais.
You're offering your commitment.
Ton offrande, ton engagement.
Let me tell you something.
Que
Let me give you this
quelque
testimony.
Chose. Que je vous donne ce témoignage. Je vous rends ce témoignage.
My two children were supposed to die during the week. Two of my children were supposed to die the same day, the same time, the same minute, the same seconds. Two.
Devaient mourir dans la semaine, même temps.
You don't understand.
Vous ne comprenez
pas. So don't
pas.
Expect what works for me to work for you when you don't do what I do.
Ne vous attendez pas à ce que ce qui travaille pour moi travaille pour vous.
It's risky to travel by the air.
Que tu ne fais pas ce que je fais.
It's risky to travel by the road.
C'est risquant de
and
travailler
we fly
en route.
Every week.
Et en route. Et nous.
The day we don't fly, we travel for
nous
hours.
Voyageons chaque
we travel
semaine.
To Quara by road
Quara,
and came back by road, the bad
route.
4-5 hours.
4-5 heures.
Ministering morning and evening for
pendant
hours.
Ministère, le matin et le soir, pendant les heures.
Staying awake at midnight.
Restant éveillé à minuit
doing
pour
midnight
prier.
Cry. Doing midnight battles.
Faisant les
raising sacrifices.
Et vivant les sacrifices.
Before I began, I raised serious sacrifice personally on behalf of myself and the church and my family.
Serious pour moi.
Serious
pour
when I say serious.
Famille,
when
serious,
I do it with joy because I know I'm helping myself.
Quand je le fais, je
every
fais
service commitment, every time you drop a sincere offering and sacrifice, you have helped yourself.